Back to 2021, we posted a teardown video of the third generation of Base's 65 watts GaN charger, which has gotten many views. You can click the upper right corner to take a look. Today we got the fifth generation of this 65 watts charger, which is equipped with two USB-C and a USB-A port. We're gonna take it apart and see if there are any improvements to the previous generation. Like all Base's products, the product is printed on the front and the specs info are on the back. Open the box. It contains the charger, cable, sticker, and documents. The Velcro cable tie can shorten and fix the cable. The 100 watts and Base's logo are engraved here. The cable length is about 1 meter. The Treasure Lab ZKM002C can detect the eMarker chip. This cable can support 100 watts fast charging. Tear off the plastic film. It's pretty similar to the previous generation. The ETL certificate is printed on the side. And the charger model CCGAN65S5 is on the other side. All specs info are printed at the bottom. It can support input of 110 to 240 volts, 50 to 60 hertz, 1.5 amp. Dual USB-C ports can support up to 65 watts output, and the USB-A can support up to 60 watts output. When charging multiple devices, the USB-C one can maintain 45 watts, and the total power won't exceed 65 watts. The input prongs can be folded. Two USB-C ports and a USB-A port are orange. The size of the charger is about 61 by 32 by 36 mm, and the weight is about 116 grams. Compared with the Apple 61 watts charger, this size is much smaller but has two more ports. After connecting it to the power supply, the indicator light at the corner turns blue. The Treasure Lab Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C one supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, PD 3.0, PPS, QC 4 Plus protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed videos of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols and PDO info of the other USB-C port are the same as USB-C one. You can choose any USB-C port to get the same charging speed. Finally, the USB-A supports FCP, SCP, AFC, and QC 3.0 protocols. Next, let's go ahead and take it apart. The weak point of this charger case is definitely the input side. After removing the button case, we found the entire module is filled with gray potting compound, and two parts are connected by metal contacts, not wires, so the input prongs can be quickly replaced during assembly. Pull out the module. It's wrapped with Mylar sheet for insulation. The cyan thermal pad at the output can enhance heat dissipation. Clean up the PCBA module. TrigiLab found it adopts QR flyback topology. Three USB ports are controlled by two independent box circuits. We also found it consists of three PCBs. The box circuits are on the right PCB, and the main PCB is at the bottom. The input time delay fuse is from Better Electronics, 3.15 amp, 250 volts. The green NTC thermistor is used to suppress the inrush current. The common mode choke is wound with magnet wires and insulated wires. The safety extra capacitor is from DGCX, 0.1 microfarad. The bridge rectifier is formed by four diodes, modulus S5 and B, 5A 1000 volts for each. Those four electrolytic capacitors are from Yongming. Three of them are 27 microfarad, 400 volts, and the other capacitor is 33 microfarad, 400 volts. 114 microfarad in total. This time, the mass control chip has upgraded to a GaN IC from South Chip. It integrates multiple working modes and adopts QFN 6x8 package. The tiny capacitor that powers the mass control chip is from Yongming, 50 volts, 10 microfarad. The largest component is the transformer, which is tightly wound with yellow tape for insulation. The SMDY capacitor is from TRX. This is a small vertical PCB, and the SMD optocoupler on it is from UTC, which is used to regulate the output voltage. The synchronous rectification controller is from Southchip. It can support adaptive turn-on detection and fast turn-off, and is also compatible with virus MOSFETs with ultra-low quiescent current. The synchronous rectifier is from LiHo Micro and adopts DFN-556 package, with standard voltage is 100 volts. Those two solid capacitors are connected in parallel for output filtering and are from Yongming NPX series, 470 microfarad, 25 volts for each. Here is the output PCB, which is equipped with three USB boards, and there are two box circuits on the back. The protocol chips of both box circuits are from iSmartWare. It can control the buck output of dual USB-C ports and integrates a variety of fast charging protocols. The 8-bit MCU is from ChipC and can automatically control the output power. It integrates a 12-bit ADC and adopts MSOP10 package. The corresponding buck MOSFETs are soldered on the main PCB at the bottom. Two groups of MOSFETs for two buck circuits are also from LiHo Micro, model is different. These are some MLCC capacitors. The VBUS MOSFET of USB-C1 is from LiHo Micro, and the VBUS MOSFET of USB-C2 and USB-A is also from LiHo Micro, which adopts DFN3x3 package, 8 milliohm, 30 volts. Those two solid capacitors are used for two box circuits. They are from Yongming NPX series, 220 microfarad, 25 volts for each. Well, that's all components of the 5th generation of BASE's 65W GaN charger. Compared with the previous generation, the progress is obvious. The GaNFET and driver have been packaged into a Southchip GaN IC, and the gray potting compound makes the charger more solid and maintains peak power for longer. So you can consider buying one if you need to charge multiple devices, or you can also upgrade to the 5th generation if you already have the older charger. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!